Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Doug, and I received another pen in the mail. It's great when you send away for really cheap Chinese fountain pens because you get another surprise in the mailbox almost every other day. This is a Baoer 388 that I ordered about 20 days ago. This was a little bit slower than normal, but it looks like a really nice pen. It's a copy of Parker Sonnet, apparently. And it comes in this little plastic sleeve. Throw that away. And it's a fairly good-looking pen. It's got the Parker arrow on it there. And it says Baoer on the cap band in gold. And 388. On the back of the cap band. The body is a sort of brushed aluminum kind of feel. You don't really feel the texture, but it's a frosty kind of a texture. The clip goes into a finial with a black dot on the top of it, and then there's nothing on the bottom. I quite like the size of this pen. It's a little bit thin for my for me, but I like that it matches my Cross Century 2. This is a rollerball pen that I've had for a number of years. And I've always liked writing with it. While I was working, this was my go-to pen every single day. It still writes okay, but now that I'm into fountain pens, I'm not writing with it very much anymore. But they're almost the same size, and they got the same kind of look. So we'll put the roller ball away and do some size comparisons with other fountain pens. I've got a Jinhao X450 snap pen. And let's see. Get them the right way around here. The Baoer is just a bit shorter. It's certainly thinner than the Jinhao. And here is a Wing Sung 3008, which is just about the same size and length as the Jinhao. So the Parker Sonnet, or the Baoer 388, is just a bit slimmer and shorter than both of these. It has a snap top cap that clicks with a very satisfying positive snap. You wonder how long that's going to last. It's sort of a friction fit. It's that plastic inner cap. Looks like some kind of a rivet that's holding the finial on. The clip is very stiff, but not unusable. It's a the cross is a little bit easier to use. And I do like that positive snap. That's what I like about the Jinhao as well. It has that nice positive click. So when you open it up, you see that it has a fairly long section that's tapered and unposted. It's a good length. So I like to write with my pens unposted, so they need to be a little bit longer so they fit my hand nicely. This is very light, and that long section is nice. You don't really feel that step unless you hold your pen up top, and there's a little bit of a rim here at the end of the section, gold rim, that sort of stops your finger. And this is my disclaimer, these are my guitar fingernails. I'm not going to trim them, I'm a guitar player. But you can write with this posted, and it does post very securely. You can feel it fit into that plastic inner cap, inner liner, and the pen sits very long in the hand at that point and feels kind of back heavy. Kind of balances there, but still, when you're writing down close, it falls back. So I would not write with it posted. It is a cartridge converter. It has a Baoer branded cartridge converter in it. And metal threads on this section here that go into metal threads in the body. Standard International fits very securely. And let's look at the nib here. It says Baoer, and it's two-tone gold. Gold plate of some sort. Whether it's real gold or not, I don't know. This pen wasn't very expensive, maybe $3 or $4. But that's a very attractive nib. It looks like a number 5 size. Plastic feed. I'm not going to try to take that nib out of there unless I need to swap it out. So, some dimensions here. The pen is 138 millimeters long capped. It is 121 millimeters uncapped, and a full 154 millimeters posted. The section length is very satisfyingly long. I like long sections. It has a bit of a, even though it's black plastic, I don't know whether you can notice that or not, but in certain lights it glows red. I can't figure out what that is. It's not transparent, but the plastic glows red, and it's not my lights. Very interesting. Nice tapered section. The section is 25 millimeters long. I put it on my scales, and the pen is 25 grams altogether. Uncapped, it is 15 grams, and the cap itself weighs, therefore, 10 grams. So not a heavy pen, especially for a metal pen. It's very attractive, and for $3 or $4, a lot less than a Parker Sonnet. So I'm going to ink this up, and we'll do a writing sample. Okay, let's see if I can ink this thing up without spilling anything or knocking the camera over. I've got some Iroshizuku Asa-Gao, which is a lovely royal blue ink that I got for my Visconti Van Gogh. So we'll try it in this little Parker Sonnet knockoff, the Baoer 388. Yeah. Two. the Baoer 388. This is medium nib. And the ink is Iroshizuku Asa-Gao. It's a fairly wet writer. Full medium line, that's for sure. That's very smooth this way. Very smooth that way. And down, very smooth. A little bit, yep. It's very smooth. A little bit in this direction. A little bit scratchy that way, but very smooth otherwise. Very wet writer. Fairly springy nib. A little bit of line variation if you wanted to. Wow. That's a very nice pen for about $4. Wow, that's very nice. I think I might use this quite a bit. Bye-bye. That's all she wrote.